Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Jasmine Destine. If you are new here, if you're returning, hey girl, hey, what's up, what's good, what's goody? Okay, period. I am back with a new type of video. So as you can tell from the title of this video and the thumbnail, I'm gonna be talking about my fitness journey that I'm currently on. But I'm going to be talking specifically about the first 3 months and how I basically was able to slim down and get a snatched waist and just shed so much weight. Like, it was a very quick but efficient time period, and I feel like there were very specific things that I did in order to garner the results that I had. And I'm going to be talking all about that in today's video. So if you guys are interested, make sure you keep watching, of course. Don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up down below at some point during the video if you find it helpful and all that fun stuff. Make sure you have your notes app pulled up on your phone and you're taking notes, or you got a little pen and paper, because I'm going to be spilling some tea, okay? Don't forget to click that subscribe button down below and join the tribe. I love you guys so much, and let's just get right into this video. Okay, so I have my notes app pulled up, so I'm gonna be looking at this from time to time just so I can like make sure that I stay on track with the notes that I've written down with you for you guys, so that I can give you all of the information. Okay, firstly, I'd like to say I don't want to scale, so I know that I lost weight based off of my waist measurements. So I do have a tape measure, so I personally feel like the scale can be very deceiving. There have been times in my life where I've like, for example, I've been 150 pounds, but 150 pounds can look different where you're holding your weight. So when I was like heavily weightlifting, I was doing a lot of working out, but I wasn't doing cardio. I was 150 pounds, but then I've also been like 150 pounds and I've been like pure fat, you know, like no muscle, no toning. So that's why I'm not really a fan of scales, but I did make sure to keep track of my waist measurements, my hip measurements, my butt measurements, and my bra, my bust, that's what it's called. I also want to say that like, I'm not a dietitian, I'm not a fitness trainer, I did not go to school for any of this. This is just my experience. That's all that I'm sharing with you guys, is my experience on what I did to lose weight. And what I did, I'm not gonna say is gonna work for everyone. Everyone's body is different, but I just want to share as much information as I can. So I moved to California last year in August, and when I first moved here, we were still in a pandemic. I moved from New York to California. So I moved into a building that had a gym in my building, but the gym was closed. So all of the amenities were closed because of COVID. So I was not working out. So from about August to March, the end of February, early March, I was not working out at all. I was in the house, everything was closed. Everything was closed. There wasn't things to do outside. So there was really no reason for me to like be going anywhere. So I just felt like I was in the house and I was eating, and I put on a lot of weight. Definitely had gained. I mean, even before I went to California, I had already put on like 15 pounds. Then California had allowed at that point in March outdoor gyms to be open, but like at social distancing, you know, 6 feet apart, and I think it was like 25% capacity. My building had moved the stationary bikes from the gym onto our rooftop, and I was able to start using the stationary bike. And I was so excited because I was just like, oh my God, like I've literally wanted to work out this entire time. I personally, and I'm gonna just state this now, I am someone that does not like working out at home. I'm not a home workouts kind of girl. I've tried it. There's just something that like I lack when it comes to motivation and working out in my home. Like, I feel like my home is like my sanctuary. It's my place of comfort. It's my place of like rest and relaxation, and I just don't want to be working out in those same areas. Like, I just hate working out at home. I don't know, like it just does nothing for me. I feel like I need workout machines. I feel like I need the treadmill, or I need a bike, or I need a Stairmaster. I need to be in that environment to feel like, okay, like let's get it, like let's get this workout in, you know? So I was like, okay, I'm gonna take full advantage of the fact that I at least have bike. Like I can bike, you know? So I would go out on my rooftop 5 to 6 times a week and I would do 30 minutes of cardio on the stationary bike. And when I was working out on the roof and I was doing these workouts, I was doing them. It was basically the first thing that I did in my day. So I would wake up, I would not eat anything. This was called a fasted workout. And I would go and I would work out for 30 minutes. Like when you do a fasted cardio workout, your body is basically using your stored fat in your body to fuel yourself throughout your workout. And I made sure to have like a good resistance on it. So I felt the burn in my legs, you know, in my thighs and in my calves. And I did it for 30 minutes straight. And it honestly, it's not as hard as you guys think it is or it may seem. It's a really easy workout. Sometimes I would like prop my phone up and be watching a YouTube video, or I'd be on the phone with my best friend, or I'd just be listening to music. Like I have a fire playlist. And before I knew it, the 30 minutes was up. I was covered in sweat. It was the first thing I did that day. I felt really good about myself. I would go down to my apartment, take a shower, and you know, start my day. I did the stationary bike for, I wanna say like 6 weeks. Then they opened up the gyms in LA and you were able to be indoors, but again, it was 25% capacity. And I was able to upgrade from the stationary bike to the treadmill. So let me talk to you guys about the treadmill, okay? There is something called low intensity interval training. So basically it's when you work out, you do cardio for a long period of time, but at a low intensity. After 30 minutes of low intensity interval training, your body kicks in and starts using your stored fat again, like I was saying earlier, to fuel your workout and to fuel you. Like your body needs a source of energy, right? So if I'm consuming a big breakfast before I go to workout, my body's going to use the big breakfast that I had in order to fuel myself through my workout. But if I choose not to eat before my workout, and I'm not going super hard because it's a low intensity. When I say low intensity, I was doing 30 minutes on the treadmill at 2.5 miles per hour, so that's like medium paced walk. I was doing it at a 15% incline. It's a really, really good workout. I feel like all you need is a good show or a long YouTube video. Put on one of my YouTube videos. Put on a weekly vlog. Put on one of those, and the 30 minutes is up like that. And again, all of this was fasted. I know fasted workouts, like the idea of working out on an empty stomach can seem dangerous, but you're not doing like a high intensity workout. You're not doing a HIIT workout. You're not really pushing yourself super hard. You're not weightlifting. You're walking uphill. That's it. You don't want to overexert yourself because then you will pass out or like throw up or have like, you know, a really bad workout. You might be really dizzy and lightheaded. So another thing that I was doing, right, in combination with all of this, I was wearing a waist trimmer. Like I was wearing a waist trimmer and then I switched over to a waist trainer. But let me talk about the waist trimmer. I had the Sweet Sweat belt. I was wearing my Sweet Sweat belt and I was using it in combination with the Sweet Sweat stick, and I really, 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 really feel like this is what helped my stomach just get super flat. So the technology with the Sweet Sweat belt is that it helps you burn fat in the area that, you know, it sits over, so your waist, your midsection. The technology, like you feel it kind of like get really warm and tingly, especially when you use it in combination with the Sweet Sweat stick. You really, really sweat. Like I worn the waist trimmer, like the waist belt, without the Sweet Sweat stick, and I'll have sweat there for sure. Like take it off, you know, my stomach is like dripping in sweat. But when I put that Sweet Sweat stick on in combination with the belt, literally pools of sweat. It was so disgusting. But honestly, honey, that's what I needed. Like I literally needed my stomach to have like all of the heat just kind of build up there and just like really melt that fat away. It was so important and it did what it needed to do. This is what helped my stomach just like super flat. I'm gonna insert photos, like obviously. At this point, like I was really starting to notice like my waist was coming in. I don't naturally have a hourglass figure. I feel like my figure is more straight. straight, like honestly, like on looking onward, but I literally start to see my waist come in. Like I start to see a curvature to my back and I'm like, oh, okay, period. So I used to wear it all the time to the point where I finished the sweet sweat stick and then I was like, okay, what's next? I want to start wearing a waist trainer, something that's going to train my waist to be more like, you know, Coke bottle curved in, really snatch you in. The difference between a waist trimmer or the sweet sweat belt versus a waist trainer has boning in it, metal boning within the construction of the waist trainer that's basically going to train your waist to be more curved. That's the whole point of a waist trainer. Think of it like a corset. Everybody knows what a waist trainer is, but I'm explaining for anybody that doesn't. I started wearing my waist trainer from J-Sculpt Fitness. I don't really see, like, I don't feel like there is a point in wearing a waist trainer if you're not going to be like dieting and working out. That's the only way that you're gonna really see the results of a waist trainer, because it's in combination with the other things. I was wearing it in a size large. I really liked this waist trainer because the boning in it was not like hard metal boning. It was like the flexible kind, so it didn't hurt. I've had waist trainers in the past that have like that metal boning that's like really hard and stiff, and those hurt so bad. But the waist trainer from J-Sculpt Fitness, I really like liked it because it was still comfortable, but I felt like it was snatching me in. So I was doing the stationary bike for like 6 weeks. Then I transitioned over to doing the treadmill, and I did the treadmill for about another 6 weeks. So I'd say this is 3 months into my fitness journey. My body had fully transformed at this point from like where I started. Like I said, I was doing fasted cardio, so I wasn't eating before I was going to the gym. The most I would have would be water or pre-workout. I will link my supplements that I use down below. I'd come back and I'd have a protein shake. The protein that I use is from Bloom Nutrition. I do have a discount code for you guys, so you can check that out down below in the description box. It's code Jasmine. Save you some coins. So I'd make a protein shake, usually consists of like a banana, one scoop of protein, some almond milk, maybe some strawberries or some frozen fruit, and ice. For lunch, maybe I'd have like a salad with, you know, some croutons or a side of bread, or I'd have like even a sandwich, but I made sure that I stopped having carbs past 8 p.m. So I would have dinner, but my dinner was a keto meal. My dinner always consisted of a protein and a vegetable, so it was high protein, high fat, low carbs. Like that was my diet. And I felt like that in combination with the cardio, which was super simple to do, is what helped me really slim down. So I wore my waist trainer from J-Sculpt Fitness in a size large until it did not fit me anymore. When I moved to California last year, I knew my waist was a 34 inch waist. And when I went and I measured myself, I was at a 30.5 inch waist. And I was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I lost 4 inches off of my waist simply from just doing like light cardio. I didn't like starve myself at all. I ate food when I wanted food. I just made sure to cut out like the obvious things like sugary foods, you know, salty foods, processed foods, things that like, you know, you shouldn't be eating if you're working out. Like the stuff that we like to indulge in, but we know that we shouldn't be eating. Like I obviously cut those things out, and I was eating, you know, high protein, high fat, low carb meals that like I was definitely in a deficit. If you don't know what those kinds of meals look like or what that would consist of for you, then you definitely want to be tracking your calories, counting your macros, using an app that could do all of that for you. One that I used to use like years ago was MyFitnessPal. That one's a really good one because they have like a barcode scanner. How many carbs it has, how much protein it has, how much fat it has. You can just scan the little barcode and then the item will pop up and you just put in how many servings of it you had. That's something that you can do, but I feel like I've gotten to a point where I know like what I need to consume in order to be in a deficit. And now I've actually transitioned. My goal right now is not to lose weight. I'm actually trying to build muscle and put on weight because we all want a fat booty. So right now, like, my entire workout regimen, my diet, everything has shifted to something completely different. And I will talk about that in the future, like in a future fitness update video. But I wanted to give you guys a full breakdown of what I was doing in order to lose weight, because I got so many DMs and so many questions about like what my workout routines are and what I'm eating and how did I do it, and people telling me that I inspire them on a daily. And it makes me so happy because I'm inspired by you guys. I feel like the fact that I was sharing and I was so candid about my fitness journey and what my goals were for myself, I felt like I had to stick to it because I shared it with you guys. And I felt like you were gonna be like, hey, I thought you said that you was doing this, and I thought you said that you wanted to be here. Why are you eating this? Why are you doing this? Like, I definitely wanna do more videos about my fitness journey on my channel, but I just wanted to start off with this one. If there are questions that you guys have, then make sure you definitely leave those down below. I love responding back to you guys. Let me know down below if you guys are on your own fitness journey or if you're thinking about starting one. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up down below. Go ahead and click that subscribe button, and I'll see you in my next upload.